Is sleeping 8 hours a night a health risk? I was always taught that 8 hours is ideal, but recent research has shown this may actually be a health risk. Over the last 10 years, there have been dozens of studies that have followed millions of people over time. They have found that there's a U-shaped relationship between the risk of mortality and the amount of sleep you have. Too much sleep or too little sleep are both linked to higher risk of mortality. The lowest amount of risk is not at 8 hours, but actually at 7 hours. Long sleepers and short sleepers have a higher mortality risk. It's important not to be too precise with the numbers, however, as people are not very good at measuring exactly how long they sleep for, because, well, they're asleep. Generally, people overestimate the amount of sleep they get. The stats show that people who sleep less than 6 hours a night have a 12% higher risk of mortality than those in the 6 to 8 hour range. And people who sleep 8 hours or more a night have a 30% higher risk of mortality. Short sleep has been shown to increase blood pressure and limit the body's ability to utilize glucose, which can drive diabetes. It can also lead to alterations in your metabolism and weight gain. Short sleepers are more likely to develop cardiovascular disease, have accidents, memory problems, moodiness, impaired thinking ability, and a weakened immune system. Essentially, if you don't sleep enough, you're more likely to develop a range of health problems. While the link from limited sleep to mortality is not as strong as the link between smoking or physical inactivity or obesity is to mortality, it still is important to manage. The association between the lack of sleep and the high risk of mortality may be driven by other factors that are affecting sleep and mortality, such as higher stress. Would increasing the amount of sleep of these high-risk individuals have a positive impact on their health? Well, probably. Experts are a little bit divided on that. What they do agree on, though, is that there is a link between sleeping a long time and poor health. However, correlation does not equal causation. Long sleep is often a symptom of other health issues, such as depression. The increased risk of mortality with long sleepers may not be a result of the extra sleep, but may be an indication of an underlying condition that the person may not know they have. It's hard to be confident because most studies focus on short sleepers because they're funded by pharmaceutical companies that manufacture sleeping pills. Sean Yunsted from Arizona State University is one of the few people who has studied the effects of long sleep. He completed a small study with young people who spent 2 hours more in bed a night for 3 weeks. They had increases in depressed mood, inflammation, soreness, and back pain. So it's possible that the negative effects from long sleep is driven by extended periods of inactivity. So how long should we sleep? Annually, the National Sleep Foundation in the US polls a random scientific sample of adults, and they found that the median amount adults sleep is 7 hours, and this aligns to the median amount for adults globally. The majority of adults that sleep 7 hours a night report feeling rested and energetic. Experts agree that there's something special about 7 hours sleep that seems to align to what adults naturally get and what aligns to the lowest risk of mortality. So less than 6 hours a night has a higher risk of mortality. More than 8 hours a night seems to be linked to mortality issues as well. Somewhere between 6 and 8 hours is the ideal amount for most adults. If you're an adult that consistently spends less than 6 hours in bed a night, you run a much higher risk of many health problems. If you enjoy sleeping, you spend a lot of the time in bed and you feel perfectly healthy, you're probably just fine. There's no sure evidence that sleeping more than 8 hours will kill you. Keep in mind with all of these figures, they're just for adults. Babies, young children, teenagers, the elderly, they require different amounts of sleep. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe below. Thanks for watching.